So this started out as a blog post, and I've been writing so much poetry lately that I think it kind of turned into a spoken word. So it's kind of long, so I'll read it, but let's see how it goes. It's called The Down and Dirty About Dating. As I see the way society treats relationships so flippantly, I have to wonder what happened to the way we used to date. Words like commitment have become synonymous with imprisonment and captivity. Commitment has all but lost its meaning of diligence, dedication, and constant effort to protect something precious. Even the concept of relationship has become too intense, too much of an emotional entanglement. So we simply say we're dating to keep our options open. Calling someone boyfriend is just too confining. We don't want to be closed-minded by limiting ourselves when someone better might be just around the corner. Our happiness is dependent on our openness, right? No, but our selfishness is. Even when we get in a committed relationship, we keep our eyes wide open, one eye on the present guy and the other on future prospects. And we keep in mind past relationships because some men just become more handsome in hindsight. I mean, let's be honest here. How many exes have you unfriended or deleted numbers from your phone? I remember thinking that the world was crazy when it introduced online dating. I mean, how many options does a person need? But the thing is, we can have all the smiles, winks, and flirts in the world, and it wouldn't be enough. Flirting has become a game. Even if you're not interested, the chime on your phone lets you know someone else is. And so we play the game, wanting to feel wanted. We crave the compliments, the clever banter, the cat and mouse conflict. It's as if our self-confidence depends on it. Why can't we be confident without it? Why isn't one special someone's words of endearment, encouragement enough? Why do we always want more? Apparently, online dating is too much of a commitment. So there's Tinder for something less serious, and you can have emotional affairs with as many people as you can let fill up your inbox. Or forget emotion, you just want to cuddle without the pressure to date or chat. Well, there's even an app for that. The deeper issue here that is that instead of being thankful for what we have, we covet what we lack. We combine the attributes of boyfriend's past, his personality with his humor and his abs to create the perfect man. But once we come to the conclusion the ideal just doesn't exist, we comfort ourselves by craving not the perfect, but the next obsession, the next fix, the next confusing emotional mess that we ditch the second it becomes too difficult. Or we back out because we get bored. Bored is my least favorite word. Saying you're bored is becoming as trendy as hipster beards and as common as saying you're hungry. Who'd have thought boredom could be attractive? It's really not. With our expectations of needing to be entertained, anything that doesn't seem thrilling must supposedly be boring. But I beg to differ. I want the mundane to be just as riveting as something exciting. To experience this begins with me internally. Someone once said that happiness is an inside job. It is. So is contentment and commitment in a relationship. It starts in the heart before we meet a prospective mate. If we aren't satisfied with ourselves, how could we be satisfied with someone else? And if you've settled in the relationship, don't you dare mention the L word too soon, or you may just lose who's dating you. Love may be a four-letter word, but since when has it become a negative thing? We want the flirtatious falsities from strangers and then freak out when we find someone actually cares. Are we too afraid to love ourselves that we can't fathom how someone else could? I don't know about you, but I don't crave the half-baked compliments from insincere men who only want what they can get. Maybe I'm single since I filter out the fakes who only want face curves or legs. Or maybe I'm single because I want a relationship, love, and commitment in a world that's becoming fast food everything. But that's the thing. We know it's killing us. We just keep eating and eating, feeding our obesity.